But first, okay. This is bizarre, and I don't know. Well, of course, it's true, but I want to talk to you about it.
Yeah.
You're friends with The Bachelor.
Yeah.
You're friends with Nick.
I'm friends with Nick. Okay. So this photo was taken.
That's I think real.
It was the night that.
That's
the,
not a cardboard cutout. That
Force Awakens came out. This is my friend Kyle, and that's how I know Nick.
Through Kyle.
Through my friend Kyle.
And you guys are just posing because you were there for Star Wars.
For Star Wars, yeah. It was Cine Family did a screening of it. We watched it, and yeah, I mean, I've known Nick since before he became The Bachelor, which is the craziest thing.
But did you know him from Bachelorette?
Did not know him.
Really?
So my friend Kyle saw him at Lollapalooza and like recognized him, took a photo with him. They became friends, and they started hanging out. Nick moved out to LA, and they became fast friends. And so he was just around, and I would hang out with him, and I kind of knew about his Bachelorette experiences and found it fascinating.
Yeah, me too.
And then, apparently, and then
I love The Bachelor. I love Nick, but I mean, I love the idea.
Of The Bachelor.
Of The Bachelor, yeah.
So I knew that he was The Bachelor before it was announced and everything. Yeah. And then he was on, and then he, you know, then he's on lock for 2 months, and nobody knows what's going on.
What does on lock mean?
He's doing the show. That's what I'm saying.
I know we're talking about this stuff.
It's fascinating.
So he's on lock.
Yeah. Not communicating with
anybody. You can't use a cell phone.
That's right.
You can't check the interweb.
Not the internet.
You can't phone call anyone.
It's not even like jail where you get your call.
No, it's worse than jail.
It's worse than jail.
Worse than jail. So Nick is there.
Except you got 20 girls that you got to decide.
20 beautiful women.
Yeah.
But it's real, right?
It's real.
He's looking for love.
Yes. He is.
I kind of looked inside your brain.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing about Nick.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people.
Spin-off show. Here's the thing about Nick.
Here's the thing about Nick.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people question whether he is real, or if that is really him on the show in the way that he's presenting himself.
Yes.
And that is him. He's a very genuine individual. He's got a lot of integrity. I can unequivocally say that.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, so this when he's crying and stuff. Do you watch the show?
I now have started watching the show because I'm so curious. I've never seen the show in my life.
And
because I know Nick, I'm like...
I know, but do you watch the show?
I watch the show every Monday.
Me too!
Yes!
And the show's fantastic!
It's really weird.
Corinne?
Corinne.
What is going on with Corinne?
And
what is happening?
And her platinum vagine.
Her vagine.
I know.
The PV? The PV.
It is.
I turn on my TV and watch the PV.
Right?
You know what I'm saying?
It's kind of like a weird human experiment. I don't understand it. I find it equal parts entertaining. I'm excited for Nick to find love.
My head hurts.
I'm also disturbed.
You are.
It's disturbing.
Yes, it's a weird experiment that I don't know why people do this.
Because, in 2 months, these girls feel that they're in love with him.
Yeah, they're crying.
Right.
And, like, going, like, I just thought this is real. And you go, you've only been here 3 days.
What I love. I know. What I love.
What if they're like that at, like, McDonald's when they're done with the breakfast menu? You're like, hey, what do you mean you don't have any griddles?
What I love is over the last couple of weeks, Nick keeps talking to them about their relationship. Each girl, like, you know, I feel like
Dude,
to move our relationship
think he's gone
further.
Crazy.
And I'm like, what relationship?
Yeah, what is he
happening?
Talking about?
Well, the relationship is going to happen
good,
eventually.
Though, man. He's good on a TV personality because he can talk about nothing. I mean, there's scenes where I go, I would be like, I don't know what to say to you, man.
Right.
I have nothing. This is weird. But he's like, so you're eating that lobster? And that's kind of the way I see him talking.
Right.
A lot of, like, questions and... You go, girl. You're an all-star. You're an all-star, is what he said to one of them. What are you talking about? No one says that to anybody.
It's pretty remarkable, because if you think about it, you're not going to connect with all of those women.
No way.
And so 9 times out of 10, you're going to be sitting with someone on a one-to-one that you have nothing in common with. And so for him to be able to actually make it seem like there is something in common is kind of amazing in those scenarios.
And then he talks to the... What's the host's name again?
Oh, I can't remember his name.
Chris.
Chris, everybody knows.
Chris. Yeah, I'm joking. Of course we know Chris. We're joking, duh. Obviously.
Have you been watching it for all 21 seasons? I had no idea that there were 21 seasons.
Is it Chris Harrison?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Good work.
Thank you. I thought, I know the guy's great. He's fit, but then he goes
he
like,
is great.
He just busts in the room. Sometimes he's cash.
What are you thinking about, Nick?
Sometimes he's cash.
Yeah.
Sometimes
What's
he's
on
in
your
suit.
Mind?
Sometimes he's got a crooked tie.
Right.
He didn't stand it. Comes in, he's like, girls, can I talk to you for a second? And he goes, tie a little, but it doesn't matter because he's the man. He walks in, he owns the place, but then he talks to Nick for a second. Hey, can I talk to you for a second? He pops up out of nowhere. Like, like Nick will be hanging out in his hotel room, then all of a sudden, it'd be like, hey, you thinking about this now? I'm just thinking about her now, right? You gotta make a decision. You only give the rose to one person, so make it count.
This is Nick thinking about what he's gonna do.
Who are you rooting for? Can I ask you that?
I've been rooting for Rachel the whole time.
Dude, what is up with that?
So what is that, right?
Wait, I'm mad almost.
I'm a little mad too because they announced that she's the bachelorette.
Which means
she's out, but we've not seen that she's out yet. So it's a big spoiler. And it's down to three. I guess I am invested.
Yeah, I mean, me too. So she's out, but I loved her.
She was my favorite.
That's my favorite.
Always my favorite. I love Rachel. But it's great that she's going to be the Bachelorette.
I know, but so I'll watch that show.
So now
but...
it's down to three, right? If it's not Rachel.
I missed last week's episode.
What about.
I know.
Wait, that was Homecoming. Like, the.
I can't believe
I'm having this conversation. Actually, we cannot believe this.
We're talking about. We haven't seen each other in 3 years.
Yeah.
And we're talking about
this. This is insane. What have I become?
No, it's us. It's great. All right, let's talk about your movie because I really do. And then we got to talk after. Anyways, my best to Nick. I hope he finds love.
Yeah, same. I will pass on the message.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Let's talk about the film. When is it premiere on Netflix? Tomorrow?
Tomorrow, yeah.
Yeah, great. So, and what is the title again?
I don't feel at home in this world anymore.
It's a great title.
It's a great title.
And it's a reference to one of the songs that's played in the film.
Yeah, and it was inspired by, there's a Mississippi Records put out a compilation called I Don't Feel at Home in This World Anymore. Many years ago, and it's all kind of Southern roots music, and there's a song by that title. And the director and writer, Macon Blair, was given that by his friend Jeremy, and he just sort of fell in love with it, and it was sort of fitting into the context of what the main character of this film is going through. She's kind of going through an existential crisis. She doesn't feel connected to anybody, and she sort of feels like the world's a bunch of So that's kind of why that title ultimately stuck. And the movie's about her. She gets her house is robbed. Police don't do anything about it. It's reinforcing the fact that kind of nobody's doing any good in the world. She enlists her friend, played by me, who's a real weird dude, to help her find her lost things and ultimately find the perpetrators and face them. And they get in a little over their head.
But if Nick chooses Corinne... the whole thing's
can you imagine
insane.
If he
no,
chose Corinne?
No,
can you imagine?
Way. There's no way because
I think
producers
collectively we
must
would lose
love
our
Corinne.
Minds.
I rip my TV. It's hanging on the wall now.
Yeah.
I would rip because it's a flat screen.
Sure. Yeah, yeah.
It's decent mounted. Size. I'd say 48 inches.
Yep.
Larger maybe.
Yeah.
48 probably. They measure.
I reckon it's probably a 55-inch TV in your home.
Well, at least I'm saying this is around 12 inches.
Small, sure.
24. 36, 48's a big screen.
That's a big screen.
That's more than enough screen.
It's enough screen.
Yeah.
Depends on how close you're sitting to that, though.
I don't have a big apartment.
Because if you're far away, if you're
I'm not far away.
There.
I live in New York City, so I live. It's an apartment, so it's basically like this.
Oh, you live in an apartment?
So it's like this. All I can see are Nick's nostrils.
Oh, well, that's fine.
But I want his nostrils to choose anyone but Corinne's nostrils.
Sure.
I don't think... I think she's not... I don't think she's in it for this.
I don't think so either, but goddamn, is she good TV.
She's good TV.
Yeah. Gosh, you know Corinne's gonna get a spin-off of some kind.
She better get something out of this.
Right?
She's not gonna get Nick, man. No way.
No. Someone's gonna get
her
platinum Vagine.
Yeah, the PV, man. Gotta get up close and personal. Anyways, the film's out tomorrow.
It's out tomorrow on Netflix.
It was premiered at
It was at Sundance.
Sundance.
We won that grand jury prize.
Come on. Dude, that's what you got. Dude.
Thank you.
Cool is that?
It's incredible and not at all something we expected.
You did not see it coming at all?
How did you even find this comedy genre film? We didn't anticipate it win the grand jury prize.
Because it gets a little crazy as the movie goes on. But dude, your character has a rat tail.
He's got a rat tail.
And it's fantastic.
Thank you.
I would have been like, I'm in whatever this movie is, I'll do it.
Just on the rat tail alone.
You should tell Nick to get one.
There you go.
What do you think he's dreaming about right now?
I don't know. I have a lot of questions for Nick.
I have a lot of questions for Nick.
He can't answer those questions, though.
But do you run into him, and does he talk?
I think it's like a $5 million fine if he reveals something. So he can't talk to anybody. Imagine that.
I'm just trying to do the math.
You're living in the world.
But what if he does a couple endorsements?
Right. He lines them up, and then he just starts.
And then he just tells the
secret. Just spills the beans?
Yeah, he's the first bastard to tell on.
Well, maybe it's fair, because they've already spoiled Rachel,
hey, Rachel,
right?
So he's like, she's still on the show. It's like, wait, you just ruined it for everyone.
Right.
What's the deal? We love Rachel.
Tit for tat.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
Yeah.
Show. Are we going to show a clip?
Yeah, we have to.
Okay.